The NetSuite Multiple Prices feature allows you to set different prices for individual items. Let's take a look at the Multiple Prices feature, including what it is, how to set it up, and how to use it in NetSuite. What are some of the use cases for multiple prices? Some companies may sell items both retail and wholesale. Using the Multiple Prices feature, it would be simple to set up a wholesale price and a retail price for each of your items. Other companies may want to set up a custom price for specific customers. These are just a couple of the situations in which the Multiple Prices feature would be necessary. Let's take a look at how you would set up the Multiple Prices feature. First, you will need to enable the Multiple Prices feature. You can find this feature in the Sales section of the Transactions tab in Enable Features. Your next step is to create the different price levels that you will use. NetSuite allows you to set as many as 1,000 different pricing levels, though most companies would not find that many levels useful or necessary. To create a new price level record, navigate to Setup, Accounting, Setup Tasks, Accounting Lists, New. On the Accounting Lists page, select Price Level from the list. To create a new price level, you'll need to name the level and select a markup or discount percentage. The percentage will be applied to whatever price is listed as the base price. If you're editing an already existing price level record, you can select the checkbox Update Existing Prices to automatically update the markup or discount of any items that are using this price level. You can also use the checkbox Online Price Level to designate the price that would be used in your online store. Your next step will be to connect your price levels with your item records. To do that, navigate to the list of items and select Edit next to one of your item records. On this item record, open the Sales Pricing subtab. You'll see a list of all your active price levels. The first price listed is the base price, and any following price levels that have an associated percentage will auto-populate off of the base price. Price levels that do not have an associated percentage will remain blank until you fill in your desired amount. You can also set price levels for specific customers that purchase items within a pricing group. A pricing group is just a group of items that you associate together to assist with purchasing and selling. To define a price level for a customer, open any customer record in edit mode and scroll down to the financial subtab. Then select the group pricing subtab. Here, you can associate this customer with a specific pricing group and price level. On a transaction, you would associate a price level with each individual line item. For example, on a sales order, you would scroll down to the item subtab, select a specific item, and then use the dropdown in the price level column for that item to choose which price level will apply on this sales order. And of course, if you are creating a sales order for a customer that has a price level listed for items in a pricing group, then if you add items that belong to that pricing group, the related price level will apply. With the NetSuite Multiple Prices feature, you can easily manage and track different prices for all your items and customers. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at suiterep.com.